Hello and welcome back. Last time we had learned how to create an inventory solution using tables in four different worksheets. Now, can we do the same thing in a single worksheet? Yes, we can do that. So here we have the raw data for our items list. Then we have the receive goods headers here. We have the issued goods headers and finally the stock and the headers here. Now let's see how we can accomplish this inventory solution in this single worksheet. So we click inside our raw data, go to insert, click on table, and the selection is perfect. This is the selection, then my table has headers, yes, fine, okay, so the table will be created. Now, in the table tools in design, if you want, you can remove this. So I'm going to remove this for clarity. So I'll click on this, and you see, you get only the headers highlighted. Now, before I go any further, let me go to formulas and check what table name has been assigned to this. So it is table number 1. Perfect. Close. So now in the received goods, we enter our serial number like we did last time. And in the description, we need not enter anything. We can get the data from our items list. So we say equal to VLOOKUP. And we want to look up the value for the serial number 1. Where is the table array? That is our table 1 here. So we will just write this and select the table 1. The description is in column 2 in table 1. So we'll write 2 here. And after the comma, we want an exact match. And press the tab key. And parenthesis closed. Now you see, while I'm doing this, the table 1 has been selected. And I press enter now and I get the description matches. Similarly for the unit, we use VLOOKUP and get our unit based on this serial number. And our table array is again table 1. Our unit is in column 3. This is the column 1, 2 and 3. So we write 3 here. We want to get an exact match. We select false. And parenthesis close and press enter. So we have this data now. We can click inside this and convert this also into a table by going to insert, table, and the new window that pops up tells us this is the selection, the table has headers, which is perfect. Okay, so it's done. If you want, you go to table tools, design, and you can remove the banded rows. Now we can enter a quantity received, let's say 100. And we press the tab key and you can see that the table is ready to accept more data. So if I write 2 here, or let's say 7, and press the tab key, we get our description and the unit and we can enter some value for the received goods if we receive the number 7. But since we entered, maybe we received something, so 50. And we press the tab key and we are ready to enter more data. But this should be enough as a demo. Now, in the issued goods, we do the same thing. We go here to, and let's say we select serial number 1, press the tab key. Now, we use the same strategy with VLOOKUP. So, VLOOKUP, our lookup value is in N4. We want to get the data from our table 1 because that is our master items list. The description is in column 2 of that table 1 and we want to get an exact match. Parenthesis closed and there it is. So for the unit, we do the same thing with VLOOKUP. We want to look up this value in our table array, table 1. The unit is in column 3 and we want to get an exact match. and parenthesis close and press enter. So let's say we issued now for this one, let's say we issued 50 and we press the tab key. You see nothing happens. It just goes to the next cell. So we convert this also into a table. We select inside this area our data, raw data, go to insert, table. Selection takes place and the create table window tells you what it is doing. Click on OK and it's done. Again, we remove the banded rows, keep the title colored, but we remove the banded rows from the data. Now we reach our stock area. So let's say we look for serial number 1, press the tab key. And again, to get the description, we just use VLOOKUP. So VLOOKUP will give us the data for the lookup value 1 from the table 1. Description is in column 2, comma, exact match, parenthesis close, and enter. So for the unit, we do the same thing with VLOOKUP. So we want to look up this value. It's again in table 1 and the unit is in column 3 and we want an exact match. Now, how do we get the total quantity received? Now, you see, our total quantity received will come from here. So let's select this, for example. This is our table 2. You can see here when I select this data without the headers, I get table 2. So the total is going to come from here. We go to our stock here and we will use the SUMIF function. We will look for the range, which is our serial number in table 2. So we will say table 2, that's our goods received, square bracket, and we'll take the serial number, close the square bracket, comma. Now our criteria is also the serial number because we are going to add the total quantity received for a specific serial number for a specific product. So we'll say tab, so we have the table 2, then S, so we get the serial number, square brackets closed, comma. Our sum range will be the quantity in table 2. So table 2, and we press Q from the keyboard, quantity received is highlighted, square bracket closed, and parenthesis closed, and press enter. So we get 100 here for 1. Let's see whether that is perfect. So here you see received goods for 1, we have 100. So if I click here now and again receive some goods for serial number 1 and I add here 50 and press enter. Now let's go to our stock and see, and that has changed. Okay. Now we are going to do a similar thing for received goods, that is the total. So the total quantity issued will come from the table 3. So we will say is equal to sum if. Here our range is table 3. And we want to get our serial number data, that is the range from which we are getting the data. Our criteria will be again serial number. So data is coming from table 3, that is the issued goods, and we are going to write serial number, square bracket close, comma. Our sum range is of course going to be this here, that is the quantity issued in table 3. So table 3, square bracket open, Q, so we get quantity issued selected. We close that bracket, close the parenthesis, press enter. So you see this matches perfectly. So if I go here now and again issue, let's say number 1, automated. So let's say I issue 60 and press enter. Now I should get 110 in my total quantity issued. So what is my balance? My balance is equal to this minus the quantity issued. Now for the reorder flag, that means we want to place a flag here which will warn us that our balance is zero and or less than zero. And if we have some balance, we will not get a flag. So the first thing we do is we use a if function. So if bracket open this value is less than zero, then assign it the value 1, else leave it blank, and parenthesis closed. So the first thing we will do is try and highlight this by using conditional formatting. So we'll go here to conditional formatting, we'll go to manage rules, and here we'll create a new rule. So we will say format or use a formula to determine cells to format. So we want to format this cell based on a formula. So I'll click here, just make this smaller, select this cell, and if that is greater than this cell, then I want to do a formatting. Or I can even say no formatting for that matter. So I need not use here absolute reference. So I'm just removing that. And let's say we don't have any formatting for that. Okay. So it's done. We'll now create a new rule. Again, we'll use this formula, and here we'll say if this value is less than this value, then we'll do a formatting. So what will we do here? We will fill our cell with a red color to warn us, and the font we can change the color because we are doing red, so we can make it white and bold. Okay, so this is how it will look. And again here I can remove the absolute reference, I would say you try it both ways, with the absolute reference and without the absolute reference, that is this relative reference. So okay, and we say apply and okay. So there is no formatting. Now if what happens if the total quantity issued becomes greater than this? So let's have a look at that. So I'm going to go here and make this 100. So you see here the formatting has changed. And do you notice you get 1 here? Because we have said if this value is less than 0, then give it 1. Now we do the conditional formatting to get a flag here. So we go to conditional formatting, manage rules, and we create a new rule here, and we take format all cells based on their values, and in the edit the rule description we take the icon sets. We can take this if we like, but we have said we want a flag, so we will go here and select the flags. So you see we get 3 colors. I'm going to just reverse the icon order, you'll see why. So I've read here, I'll say when this value is greater than equal to 0, then give us a red flag. For this one we don't want an icon, so no cell icon, and for this also we'll say no cell icon. So this, if this condition is met, we should get a red flag here, And we will also say, click here and say, we only want to see the icon so that this one will not be there. So, okay. And you see now, this says that this applies to the current selection. So what we'll do here, we'll go here and we'll say, applies to oops, it's not there. So we can also select worksheet, or we'll keep the current selection. No problem. All right. And we'll say apply. Okay. So you see there, you get a flag. In this manner, you can create a lovely inventory solution using tables in a single worksheet. I hope you found this interesting and useful. Thanks for watching.